Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today I thought it'd be fun to use some things that I almost forgot about. I literally spent like 3 hours in my beauty room this morning just going through everything. Initially I was planning on like organizing stuff, but then I got distracted and I started to dig through all of my drawers, and I found things in certain drawers at the very back that I completely forgot about and I really wanted to use them, so I decided to kind of do that per category. There's a mixture of things here. There's some drugstore and some high-end. But these are things that I have not used in a very long time, and I'm actually excited to use them again because I forget how I feel about certain products. I haven't used this eyeshadow palette in so long, so I hope you guys are excited. Let's just get right into it. So for brows, I found this. This is from Benefit. It's the Brow Contour Pro. This is in the shade Brown Light. So this is the pen that like has the highlighting shade and the deeper shade for like the toward the end of the brow. It has a definer. Anyway, it's been so long since I've used this. So I'm gonna use the deep shade. The thing I remember about this already is that it does not have a spoolie on the end of it, obviously, because there's so much in here. They probably didn't have any room for a spoolie, but I'm just gonna go ahead and fill my brows with this. So I'm gonna use the dark pencil on the outer portions of the brow first. This has a very unique formula and it's not a very fine pointed applicator, so I'm feeling like things are looking a little bit muddy already. I remember liking this product, I just think it takes time to build it up to what you want it to be. So I think that's enough of the dark shade. I'm gonna click my pen and use the lighter shade. And I'm gonna start to fill in the front portion of the brow with the lighter shade. And then I've got my other brow pencil to use the spoolie just so I can brush through the brows as I'm going. Okay, that looks pretty good. We'll go ahead and do this side. Okay, and then I'm gonna use the definition shade, which is like basically a concealer. And I'm gonna use this above and below the brow. So I'm kind of drawing it a little bit outside of where I actually have the brow product. And then I'm gonna take a small flat brush and I'm gonna use that to buff out this product along the edges of the brow just to kind of clean things up a little bit. And same thing above the brow actually, just to make sure that everything looks nice and precise. I feel like that really helped clean things up, don't you, compared to this brow? Let's do this brow. Okay, now that I have that blended out, I'm gonna use the highlighter shade, which I believe is supposed to just be used underneath the highest point of the brow. So I'm just gonna kind of scribble some right about there, and I'm gonna use the same exact brush as earlier, and I'm gonna blend that out. Well, I feel like my brows actually look pretty nice after that. It's definitely a lot more work than what I'm used to with just my normal brow pencil, but I don't know, I kinda like it. I'm gonna take my spoolie one more time just to make sure everything is blended and the brow hairs are in the right place. Okay, I'm gonna use my NARS Tinted Smudge Proof Eyeshadow Base. This one is in the shade Medium. I'm trying to use up a little bit more of the medium shade because I'm almost out of the light. This is not something I've forgotten about, but the eyeshadow palette I'm gonna use, oh my gosh, you guys, I completely forgot about it. You guys know that I love to do my Full Face of Nothing new series on my channel, which this is kind of similar, but not really, because usually when I do those videos, I have certain products in mind that I really wanted to use again or whatever. I haven't thought about this palette in a long time, and it doesn't mean that it's like a bad thing or a bad product. I just honestly, I have been distracted by new launches and it got pushed back in the back of my eyeshadow drawer, and you know, when it's out of sight, it's out of mind. So this is the Urban Decay Naked Cherry palette. The tones in here are so pretty. I really like this palette. I mean, as far as I remember, I really like this palette at least. So I wanted to use this today. I'm gonna start with this shade right here. This is called Caution. I'm gonna get that on a fluffy brush and I'm gonna start to blend this into the crease a little bit, kind of as our transition shade. So I'm kind of just building this shade up in the crease, and then I'm taking what's left and really buffing it up toward the brow and out toward the end of the brow. I want to create something really pretty and smoky, so I want to make sure that this shade blends into the brow area nicely, just so that everything we put on later can blend up into this color and it won't look weird, you know? Next, I'm going to dip into this shade right here. This is called Feels. It's a beautiful kind of mauve-y tone. I'm going to tap off the extra, and this is the shade that I really want in the crease mainly, so I'm going to start buffing it there. Same thing on this eye, focusing on the crease. And I am kind of bringing it down almost like I would a halo eye, but I'm not planning on really doing a halo eye. We'll see where it goes, actually. But I'm bringing it down in this inner portion here and this outer portion, and then kind of leaving the center a little bit more bare. Okay, now that there's less product on the brush, I'm going to take this and start to blend it up into that existing shade that we applied initially. Because again, I want everything to be super blended out and super smoky. And I kind of want some of this pink shade going into the brow slightly. Okay, I'm going to take the shade Ambitious. And I'm actually going to start to press this on the eyelid. And this is where we're going to start to build up that smoky eye. So I'm kind of using this and lightly packing it up against the lash line. And then I'm buffing it up to the crease, and I'm going actually all the way across the eyelid for this. All right, next I'm gonna go into this shade right here called Devilish, and I wanna start to build up the intensity on the outer corner. So I'm just gonna start pressing this on the outer portion and then blending it into the crease. I'm also gonna take what's left on the brush, and I am gonna kind of create a little bit of a halo effect by applying some of that deep shade in this inner portion of the eye as well. I wanna make things even more intense, so I'm gonna take this dark brown called Privacy. I'm just going to take the same brush and I'm going to layer that shade right over top of the Devilish shade that we just applied, just to kind of intensify that a little bit more. And with what's left on the brush, I'm just going to kind of apply a little bit into that inner portion to keep with the halo effect. Okay, I'm going to take a clean, fluffy brush and just run over the entire top portions of this eye look just to make sure it's nice and blended. Okay, next I'm going to take the shade Turn On, and I want this to be kind of the center focal point of the look, or the center of the halo. So I'm just gonna pack that on the center of the lid, blending into the existing shades a little bit on the sides. So I'm actually going in with a brush and I'm taking the shade Caution, which is the one we initially applied, and I'm just kind of applying a little bit more up toward the brow. I feel like things are getting a little crazy by the brow here. Whoops. So I'm just trying to make sure that it's all super blended. I'm gonna take that Turn On shade and I'm gonna use my finger now to intensify the shimmer in the center of the lids. Okay, this isn't part of the things I forgot about, but I'm gonna use the Persona eyeliner. This is the waterproof eyeliner in the shade Plum. And I'm just gonna use this to line the entire top lash line. This eyeliner goes so well with the tones in this palette, actually. It's so pretty. And I'm lining from inner corner to outer corner, but I'm keeping the inner corner eyeliner a lot thinner than when I come out here. And then I'm going to thicken it up a little bit. I'm not doing a wing or anything, but I do like to kind of extend the eyeliner out slightly. So that palette had quite a bit of fallout, especially with the deeper tones. So I'm going to take a makeup wipe and just make sure to clean up the edges. Okay, then once I use the makeup wipe, I always like to take my finger and just press down the edges so that they're not too harsh. Okay, so I was looking through my drugstore mascara drawer and I came across this L'Oreal Voluminous Superstar X Fiber mascara. I don't remember the last time I used this, which means it's probably expired, but we're gonna use it. I'm gonna use the first side. It's just labeled as one, and I'm gonna go ahead and apply that to my lashes. I'm actually gonna do one eye at a time, so I'm gonna switch over to the second side, which I believe this is like the fiber mascara. This is step two. So I'm gonna go ahead and build that up on the top lashes. I actually really like that. Made my eyelashes look very voluminous. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and do the other side. Okay, so there's mascara on the top. I'm actually gonna take that same Persona Plum eyeliner and I'm going to apply it in the top waterline on just the outer third. Okay, the mascara is dry. I'm gonna go ahead and buff off mascara marks. Next, I'm gonna go into my Bobbi Brown Vitamin Enriched Face Base. I was watching YouTube this morning and then a Bobbi Brown tutorial just randomly started playing and it made me think of this product. This is actually the thing that kind of inspired me to do this video altogether, because I started to look through my drawers being reminded of all these things that I own and used to love so much that are still really good products, but there's just so much makeup that's always releasing that I feel like it's so easy to forget about such good products like this. Okay, so now that that is on the skin, I'm gonna be using the NARS Natural Radiant Longwear Foundation. This is something that I used to use all the time, and I've actually seen a lot of people continue to use this ever since it launched. But for me, like, I just like kind of moved on to different foundations, not because this one is bad or anything. I forgot. So I'm gonna go ahead and use my Real Techniques buffing brush, and I'm gonna go ahead and start to apply this all over the skin. I'm using the shade L4 Deauville. So I'm just kind of evenly distributing this all over the face first. And then I'm gonna take my beauty blender and I'm gonna take what's left on the back of my hand and I'm gonna press the foundation into the skin. Okay, that looks really nice on the skin. I honestly can't remember how I feel about this as far as the wear goes. So I will leave a note in the description down below. letting you all know how I feel about the foundation, even though I've already tried it before. I'm gonna go into the Revlon Candid Concealer. I have not used this in so long. I'm gonna go ahead and kind of put this underneath the eye area first. This is a very yellowy shade. Maybe that's why I haven't used it in a while. And I'm gonna take my Real Techniques brush and I'm gonna start to blend this out underneath the eyes. And then once I feel like it's pretty even under the eyes, I'm gonna go back into my sponge and just press that into the skin. I actually really like that under the eyes. It's very lightweight, but I feel like it brightened everything nicely. I also found the NARS Soft Matte Complete Concealer. This was like in the back of my concealer drawer. And I'm gonna use this for blemishes. So this is in the shade Light 2.75. Just dipping directly into the pot and then applying it over blemishes. Also kind of buffing it in the center of the face as well. And then I'm gonna take my sponge and again, just make sure that that is nice and blended in. Okay, so I also came across the Revlon Photo Ready Candid Powder. I remember this powder, but I forgot about it. But when I saw it again, I remembered one thing. When I used this powder, when I did a review of the whole Revlon Candid line, this was forever ago, I tested the line under flash because it's supposed to be like photo ready or whatever, and this gave major flashback, but I remember it being a nice powder. So I'm gonna go ahead and use this for underneath the eye area. It's a very, very finely milled powder. So I'm gonna take a brush and just gonna buff underneath the eyes to set the concealer. I'm also gonna set the T-zone with this. And then I cannot believe that I almost forgot about my Jouer Soft Focus Hydrate and Set Powder. Oh my gosh, like I love this. And it has been way too long since I've used it. So I'm gonna go ahead and take just a big brush and I'm going to set the rest of the face with this, kind of using stamping motions at first. And then once there's enough product, I will buff it a little bit. Okay, let's move back to the eyes. I'm gonna take the shade Feels again. And this time I wanna make sure that there's nothing on the brush because there is some fallout with this. So I'm kind of pressing it into my hand a little bit first as well. And then I'm gonna take it underneath the entire lower lash line. Okay, I'm just taking my powder brush with whatever's left and just blending out the edges of the eyeshadow. There we go, that's a little better. All right, next I'm gonna dip into Devilish. Again, same thing, I'm gonna tap off the excess and then press it into my hand so that there's minimum fallout. And I'm going to apply this on the inner and outer portion of the lower lash line. Next, I'm gonna go into Ambitious and I'm gonna buff that in the center of the lower lash line. And I'm overlapping that over top of the matte shade we just applied. Then I'm gonna take a smaller brush and I'm gonna dip into this shade right here called Turn On. And I'm just gonna pop that on the lower lash line in the very center. I'm adding a tiny bit more of that with this small brush on the top lid just to make that halo eye super intense. Okay, I'm gonna take a little bit of Caution, which was that kind of neutral shade. I'm actually gonna use this to buff out everything underneath the lower lash line. This will just help everything flow into the under eye area really nicely. Okay, now I'm gonna take my Persona Plum Eyeliner again, and I'm going to line the waterline. Okay, and then I'm gonna go back into my Superstar X Fiber Mascara and do the lower lashes using this. Okay, I really love the eye look. For bronzer, I found this Girlactic Matte Bronzer in the shade Cabo, and I feel like I used to use this all the time. I remember loving it. The tone is really, really nice. So I'm gonna go ahead and take that on a bronzer brush, and I'm gonna start to build that up on the cheeks to sculpt and warm the complexion. So things kind of look weird right now. I'm just placing everything where I want it to be, and it looks a little bit more intense, but I'm doing that on purpose so that I can go back over everything with the brush I used with the hydrating powder. I didn't add any more of this product to the brush, but I'm just using that to blend everything out. Seems to be working very nicely, actually. Okay, next for blush, there's two blushes that I forgot about that I wanted to use. The first being my old favorite. This is from The Balm. If you've been with me from the beginning, you probably remember this. This is the Balm Balm Beach blush. It's an incredible tone. I love it. It goes with absolutely everything. I'm just gonna go ahead and pop this onto the cheeks. Oh my gosh, I love this color so much. There's so many good things that I already own. It's insane. I feel like I'm so guilty of forgetting what I already have. And I need to like use these. I need to use them up, you know? I love that one. Okay, I wanted to also take a tiny bit of the Bobbi Brown blush in the shade Pretty Pink. Just the tiniest amount of this. It's a very vibrant color. So I'm just gonna dip that into the brush, tap it off on my hand first, and then apply it just here on the cheeks to add a little bit of a pop of color right there. I'm gonna take the powder brush and just kind of stamp around the edges just to make sure everything is nice and blended. For highlighter, I want to use this right here. This is the Laura Mercier highlight. It's the Matte Radiance Baked Powder in the shade Highlight 01. It looks like this. And I'm just going to go ahead and layer that up on the face. This gives such a gorgeous natural but also blinding glow. I'm gonna put some above the brow a little bit. I'm gonna take a small brush while I have this out, and I'm gonna actually use this highlighter to create a little bit of an inner corner highlight. Also gonna use that underneath the brows. Okay, and then I'm gonna take my hydrating powder brush and just lightly buff over that as well. I am going to wipe off any foundation on my hands and then off of my lips. And I was going through my lip drawer and I found all of these Dose of Colors lip liners. I really wanted to use them. So I'm pretty sure, I think I want to use the shade Dime. It's a really pretty cool undertone and I feel like it'll kind of make my lips look contoured in a way. So I'm just going to go ahead and line the lips with this. I'm going to kind of fill the lips in with this color too. It's such a pretty shade. Okay, once that's applied, I also had forgotten about this Nude Sticks gel color. It's a lip and cheek balm in the shade J Mama. I used to love this one. I'm gonna apply this all over, right over top of that lip liner we just applied. I'm just gonna take my finger to make sure that those two colors are blended. And then in my drugstore lip drawer, I found this. This is the Wet n Wild Liquid Catsuit High Shine Lipstick in the shade Send Nudes. I thought this might be pretty on top of those more cool tone colors because it has a slightly more of a peachy undertone. So I thought it'd be pretty just in the center to warm things up a little bit. Okay, let's step back and assess the situation. I'm gonna take my powder brush and just blend everything. I actually feel like we have enough bronzer. That bronzer made me look sun-kissed quick. I like it. Oh, I forgot to find a setting spray that I forgot about. Let me go see if I can find one. Okay, I found this. I haven't used this in so long, and I always get comments from you guys saying that you love this. It's the NYX Dewy Finish Setting Spray. I don't remember how I feel. Okay, so I'm just gonna set the whole face with this. And once that is almost dry, I'm just gonna take my sponge and lightly press it down into the skin just to make sure that the makeup is nice and locked in place. Last but not least, we have brow gel. This might make the brows look a little too intense, but I wanted to use it because I forgot about this. I went through the entire clear version of this. This is the M Cosmetics brow gel in brunette, but I wanted to use this today. It might overpower the brows a little, maybe not, just because it's tinted. I'm just gonna go ahead and set the brows using this. Okay, I feel like that made my brows actually look kind of cool. They're very, very fluffy, but that's okay. Last but not least, you guys, I keep saying that, but I really want to put a little bit of this Girlactic bronzer right underneath the lower lash line. I just feel like it could use a little bit of warmth there to help tie in the rest of the tones on the face. I'm kind of blending it out and connecting it to the existing shadows on this outer corner here. Okay, I'm just like trying to fix everything. I'm wanting a little bit of brightness here, so I'm taking my Rhodial Banana Powder. This is something that's just sitting on my desk. And I'm just adding brightness right here on the sides of the nose. Okay, I think that's it. Well, I love how this look turned out, you guys. It was so much fun for me to use things that I have completely forgotten about, and now I feel like I'm not gonna forget about them again because I love how this look turned out. Everything looks and feels so luxurious, and I'm just really happy that I dug into my collection and found some of these products again, and I was able to use them again. It really goes to show you that we don't always need to be buying new things, even though there's always amazing new things launching, and I will forever be a sucker for new makeup, but this is a really good reminder for me especially to pause and take a second and really look into my collection and see if there's anything that kind of slid to the back of my drawers that I have forgotten about that I need to use again. So I really enjoyed doing this video, you guys. Let me know in the comments below if you enjoyed this and if you would like to see another episode of this, because there is so much makeup that I have completely forgotten about that I would love to pull out again and, you know, try out again. So if you guys like this video, let me know in the comments. If you're new here, hi, my name is Allie and I would love for you to join the family. You can do so by hitting the subscribe button, and if you're already a subscriber but you want to be notified on Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, click on the bell after you subscribe and you'll get a notification every single time I post. Thanks again for watching. I love you guys so much. I truly hope that you are staying safe and staying healthy at home, and I will see you all in my next video. Love you. Bye.